Hi, I'm Ali Merriam. When you go to the beauty counter at the department store, there are a lot of questions that naturally occur. Do you buy the sample? What do you sample? Well, PopSugar beauty editor Jessica Kroll is here today to give us some insight as to how to navigate this tricky place. Hello, Jessica.
Hi, Ali.
So what products do you recommend people actually try at the beauty counter?
Well, a lot of things you can get at the drugstore. So eyeshadows, blushes, you can actually see the shade well in the packaging. But when it comes to things like foundation, it's hard to get the right shade at the drugstore. So that is a perfect thing to buy at the makeup counter. You have a makeup artist there who can help you pick the right shade for you, the right coverage, and also what's gonna fit in your daily routine, what you have time for. I also think lipsticks are a good thing to try at the makeup counter because even though you can see them in the packaging at the drugstore, it never quite turns out the same when you put them on your lips. So at the makeup counter, you can try as many shades as you like. You can go crazy. And I love to do something like that. And who isn't trying out different fragrances at the makeup counter for Mother's Day or Father's Day gifts? So fragrance is also a great thing to wait and smell at the department store.
Now there's so much at the makeup counter. That's why there's someone who's actually there to sort of guide you through this large puzzle.
Yes, always use the resources that you have there at the makeup counter. They're usually professionals who know the line and who also know a lot about applying makeup. So don't be afraid to ask questions. And if the makeup artist is doing a free makeover, get tips while you're there. She can tell you what's right for your skin tone, as well as what's new coming out for the line, and maybe what's gonna get discontinued very soon, so you know what to stock up on.
Inside info.
Yes. And if you are gonna get a free makeover, just keep in mind that even though it is free, we think it's a courtesy to buy a little something as a thank you.
That seems only polite.
Yes.
Now, of course, you're not the only person who's actually trying stuff on at the beauty counter. So how do you recommend you keep things on the up and up hygiene-wise?
Yes, there is a little bit of, you know, danger in trying things at the makeup counter, but not a lot if you do it the right way. So make sure you're using the Q-tips, make sure you're using the wipes and the sponges that are provided for throwaway use. Use it once and throw away, no double dipping, because that'll only transfer bacteria into the product.
Yeah.
Don't go touching things with your fingers. It's best to use those things that they set out for you. If you use a tester, usually they have alcohol, so you can wipe it all clean after you're done. And just be hygienic as you can so the next person can come and use it safely as well.
Yeah, in this age of Purell, it's only nice to look out for the people who are gonna use it after you.
Exactly, I know one thing that beauty editors always like to do is we try colors out on our hands. So we can try products, get a feel for the texture and the color next to our skin tone without putting it on our eyes or our lips, which are very sensitive areas when it comes to bacteria.
Yeah, you wanna watch out for those things. Now, when I go to the beauty counter, it's sort of like you're a kid in a candy factory. There's so much. How do you make sure that you don't leave basically spending your whole paycheck on these new wonderful products you've just been sold?
I definitely have that problem as well. You know, I try to make a wish list before I go, so I know I'm here to get lipstick, I'm here to get mascara, that's what I need. I've gone through my kit and I know that I need all these things right now instead of just going crazy. And if you do fall victim to the sales pitch, which can happen sometimes, you know, this product is so great, you can actually return things at the department store. So that's a good thing to keep in mind. If you keep it closed and if you have your receipt, feel free to return it, it's okay.
Yeah, it's nice. You can let yourself be persuaded by the sales pitch, but you know, there's always something you can do to sort of clean things up afterwards.
Yes.
Well, thanks so much, Jessica. I personally feel very prepared to go shopping for makeup.
I'm glad.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.